What's up guys, how do you do? Welcome to today's edition of Programming Wizards TV. In this class we're going to see how to populate a list box, a wxPython list box controller with data from a list. Okay, as you can see, these are nice list box. If you select an item, then you're able to show that item in a message box. Okay, so this is wxPython tutorial and we're seeing how to work with a list box. So let's get started. So first and foremost, or what we need to actually do is to come to our index.py right here. We're going to import the wx as well as the wx.xrc packages. Then we're going to create this class called my app. As you can see, the class is deriving from the wx.app. This is actually what's going to build for us our wx application. Okay, now we're going to have the on init, which is taking in the self. The self, of course, in Python is what we normally call this keyword. In the other languages, it basically refers to the current instance of this particular class. So for example, self.frame or this.frame, and then we have Mr. Frame right here. We're instantiating it, passing in none as a parameter. Now Mr. Frame, of course, is a class that we're going to create in a short while that is going to derive from the wx.frame. So we come self.top, set top window, then we pass in self.frame, okay, which is an instance of this Mr. Frame. Then self.frame.show, we're going to show the frame right there, and then return true. Yeah, we come and have right here define our Mr. Frame class. As you can see, it's deriving from the wx.frame. Then we have our init function, which is taking in the self, which is the current instance, of course, and then the parent. Okay, then we come and say wx.frame.init. Then we're basically invoking the init method of the frame, okay, of the frame class, wx.frame class. We pass in the self, which is the current instance, and then the parent, then the id. Okay, so we're going to use the any id, and we will leave that one to wx to figure out for us an id. Then we supply the title for our frame or our form. Then of course we raise the default position. Then the size right here, this is the size 500 by 400 width by height. Then the style right there. Okay, then once we've done that one, we'll come set the background color. Then we'll come, we're going to instantiate the flex grid sizer. Then we set, of course, flexible direction to both wx.both. Then we come right here, we also instantiate the box sizer. Okay, so box sizer, then wx.vertical, we're going to arrange our items vertically. Basically we're going to have the label, as you guys saw, on top of our list box. So we come, we're going to first create a static text that you're calling the header label. As you can see, we're going to pass the text for that particular label. Okay, then we'll also come set the font, then of course add the label to our box grid sizer right there using the add method. Then we're going to create this particular list. This is a Python list. As you can see, the list comprises of some nebulas that we're going to show. Okay, basically a Python list. Then we come and say self.m list box. We instantiate our list box, wx list box. Then we pass in the id, and then the point, and then of course the size of the list box. Then we pass in right here the items that will be shown in our list box. Okay, so having done that one, we're going to add our list box to our grid sizer as well. So basically the list box is going to just be placed below our header label. Okay, then of course once you've added them to our box grid sizer, then we're going to add the box grid sizer to our flex grid sizer. Okay, so having done that one, we're going to set the instance of this Mr. Frame, which is deriving from the wx.frame. We'll set its instance to, of course, our we'll set its sizer property to my flex grid sizer. First we've added the box grid sizer to our flex grid sizer, then we set, of course, the flex grid sizer as the main layout for this particular frame, or as the parent layout. Okay, okay? Then of course it's now time to come and then bind events to our list box. We want to listen to the selection changed events for the list box. So we come self.mListBox.bind. Then we're going to come right here, pass in the type of event. So the event is wx.eventListBox. Okay. Then self.showSelectedItem. ShowSelectedItem is a method that we are going to create shortly right here, which is going to be our event handler. So in the bind method, first we pass in the event, then we pass in the event handler. So event handler, of course, let's come create it right here. Okay. So dev show selected item, this event handler, as you can see, is taking in the self right here, meaning that it belongs to this particular Mr. Frame class, and then the event right here. So the event. Okay. So we come right here, and then as you can see, basically what we'll do inside this function is to show a message box. So wx.messagebox, then event.get, event object.get string selection. We'll get the string selection, then this is what we're going to show right here, is actually like our header label, okay, the title for the message box. Then of course it's now time to run the application. If name equals to main, then we instantiate our my app, passing in false as a parameter. Then we invoke the main loop method, which is going to start our event loop, okay? And then if we now come and then run the project, very fast we have our project working perfectly. So this is it, guys. We've looked at how to work with wxListBox. Like this video, share it, and make sure you guys subscribe to our channel, Programming Wizards TV. Take care, I'll catch you in the next class.